Good afternoon. Happy Monday to all my team members, shining stars. This is Sue Dixon, your Avon upline, coming out to you today. I'm going to try to do these little short training videos on Mondays because I'm usually working in my home office in between errands and the things that I do. So they'll be at different times. So I'll try to catch as many of you as I can if you're on here. I'll try to give you like an hour's notice when I will be posting and what the topic's gonna be. But you can always do the replays later and hopefully pick something up from the conversation that the training I'm gonna be doing with you. So today I wanted to just briefly go over online trainings and daily activities. You know, how you can learn from the trainings that we have on youravon.com and what type of daily activities that I personally do that you might want to try to help you grow your business. So today I had a doctor's appointment at 10 this morning. So it's in an area I don't go to like every 3 months. It's not far from my house. I just don't go into that area very often. So when I do, I always have at least 100 brochures with me because I want to be able to get books out in those neighborhoods while I'm going to that part of town. So today I went out and got 100 books out in the area where my doctor's office is. While I was waiting to see my doctor, I waited an hour and 10 minutes. I think we should start charging them for making us wait. But while I was there, as I realized, you know, after 20 minutes went by, I'm like, well, I may be here a while before I see them. So I went onto my phone and I started doing my e-store post on different social media platforms. So I think I did at least 40 different Facebook sites, Twitter. I posted on there and then just answering some emails while I was sitting there waiting. So I'm not wasting my time. I still can work my business while I'm doing my errands, or like you said, if you're going to a doctor's appointment, you know, you use that time wisely. I left a book in the waiting room, and then when I left, I had to do a couple other errands. I went to the post office. I left a book with the lady that was in line there. I went to a lawnmower place to check on a part for my husband's lawnmower. It's not my lawnmower. I don't do lawns. I do Avon. No. But anyway, so while I was there, asked if I could leave some of my business cards there and if I could take some of their business cards to give to my customers. So right there, I was networking. You know, I can do this for you. You can do this for me. So that was just, you know, this morning. And then I touched base with the team member that's going to be placing her first order today. So I'll be talking to her around 6 o'clock tonight to walk her through those steps. And in the next couple hours, I have a few more phone calls to do and some trainings that I'm working on as well. So make sure you're planning some kind of activity each and every day. It doesn't have to take a lot of time, but it should take some time. You should be doing something daily that's going to help you increase your sales, increase your team, you know, connect with team members. That's something I'm really working hard on to do on a regular basis because my team is getting larger and larger. And some days I'm very overwhelmed with how am I going to reach 400 plus people and stay connected with them all. And it's not going to happen every day and it's not going to happen overnight. That's why I do different things like, I don't know if you've noticed, and I hope that you're enjoying them or at least viewing them, the campaign newsletter that I do for recognition and tips to show you where you are with your sales, who's making President's Club, some different tips and ideas to grow your business. So I send that to you individually through your email, and I also post it on the Facebook team page so you can view it either place, but not everybody is on our Facebook team page. I am encouraging more and more people to get on there so I can reach more of you or that you can view these live videos. But I'm also taking these live videos and turning them into YouTube videos. I finally figured out how to do that. So I'm slowly, not fast, but slowly progressing into learning these different techniques so that I can hopefully reach out to more of you on a regular basis. And so one of the things that I see that a lot of representatives are not taking advantage of and really should if you want to grow your business. And that's taking the free trainings that Avon has on Avon University. When you go on to your avon.com, it's the center tab when you sign in. You'll see Avon University. Just click on that and view the trainings. Now, there are 39 trainings. I took some notes because I went back to review because they're always updating. So there's over 39 trainings on there. Some are short little videos, some are little webinars, and they're specific to topics. So you want to make sure you go on there and do them. Let me just read you some of the ones that they have. There's actually a section off to the left. It's the little toolbar off to the left, and it'll say playlist. So you can put the certain ones you want to learn, and you can put them into your playlist so that those will come up first. But there's also the course catalog. I like that because it lists individually what's in each one of those sections. So there's one, managing your business, building your sales, knowing your products. That's one that I think everyone should take within their first couple weeks of becoming a representative. Managing your business, training and developing your team. If you are thinking of becoming a leader and starting leadership, you definitely need to do that and also do the trainings on ALMA, which is the program that you get your reports and leads through. So you definitely want to do that. There's course favorites you can do in that. There's a place for our reports. Now, many of you may not know this, and you may tell me you've done all your trainings, but did you know that I can see what trainings you've done and which ones you haven't done? So, as a leader, we can go into those reports, pull up an individual team member, and see what courses they've completed. Maybe they got a couple left to do. And then that way you can touch base with them and kind of remind them, hey, you still got a few more trainings to do. But we can see all of our team members who have completed all the courses and those that have not even started them. So you may want to touch base with the ones that haven't started any of them because it's such a benefit to us. There's so much information at our fingertips. And I always say, knowledge is power. The more you're going to learn, the more you're going to earn. And I truly believe that. And my local team members, when we have meetings, I say it all the time. You need to educate yourself about programs that are out there. You need to educate yourself about new and upcoming products. For me, my main focus is skincare. I love skincare. I love giving my customers information about it because I think it's so important to get someone on a skincare regimen. I'm not really into makeup. I mean, today I just put on lipstick probably 5 minutes before I got on here. I didn't wear any makeup. And when I do wear makeup, I don't wear much. But when it comes to skincare, I do have a regimen that I do every day. I wear the jewelry, I have some clothing, I have the shoes. But just because I don't wear a lot of makeup doesn't mean I don't know about it because I've studied. I've done the beauty advisor courses, that Avon's had in the past. And anytime there's some training locally or, that we have workshops and things, try to go to those things or just go on YouTube. There's a lot of representatives that are really awesome with doing the makeups and the techniques. So if you're not really good at that and you want to learn more about it, go on there and find those trainings. There's so many things at your fingertips and it's all free. It doesn't cost you anything. So make sure you're taking the time to do those things. The other thing I do is I have a book. These are just for my meetings, for this year. And I take notes. I mean, I am a note taker. Oops, if you can see. Every meeting I have, like this one, was for Gold Leaders and Above, Leading the Way with Avon. And I'll write down who the speaker was, If it was a representative I don't know, I go and try to find that person on Facebook and connect with them so I can ask more questions. My upline, Lisa Wilbur, does a call every other Monday, Motivational Mondays, and I write this down. So this book is all the calls I've been on this year, webinars, and we have trainings with Betty Palm, and I trainings we've had with our division managers. We have the virtual sales meetings that are going to be. We actually started one in June, but that's what it's going to be from now on, starting in July. So I try to take notes and go back and review. Like I said, try to connect with those people that were like guest speakers, and just kind of get some tips and ideas. When we've gone to sales meetings, I always take notes. Now I've been doing this 17 and a half years, and you may think, well, why is she taking notes? She knows what she's doing. I don't, not always. I mean, I don't know everything. I don't claim to know everything, but I learn something new all the time. And a lot of times it's from a brand new representative because there's a fresh set of eyes with the business. There's that excitement and enthusiasm that some newer representatives have, not so much with, the ones that we've kind of been stuck in our rut or just doing the same old. Which I did for many years, but now I'm trying, especially with technology. And as many of you that know me personally, I was fighting it for the longest time, like, oh my God, I can't keep up with all this. And just as I get to learn something, they come out with something else. But I'm just kind of forcing myself to do it because I know the more that I can do these things and get out of my comfort zone, so you see that I'm doing this too. I'm not doing the same thing all the time. It'll get easier. Sometimes you got to do something 10, 20 times, but definitely take the time and the steps to do something and learn something so that it will help you grow your business. And, once you get the hang of it, it really is fun. Like I'm enjoying doing videos. I don't like it when it stops and blocks me. And then I'm like, okay, like last week I had to re-record it, but I did it and I got it done. I'm still working on those Zoom calls. I'm sorry, guys. I'm gonna get this going. July. July is the month. It's gonna happen. I only got a few more days of June. We only got, what, 4 or 5 more days of June. But I will be doing Zoom calls, and those will be on a consistent evening. I probably will try like maybe a Monday afternoon, and then maybe Monday evening. Keep it the same day, but do a morning. Or, afternoon one and then evening. So I'll probably do two a day, just so hopefully I can reach more of you and get more of you on. So that is something I promise I'm gonna do. I just gotta get going on it. I'm sorry, it's taken me a while on that one. The other thing, like I said, I started doing the newsletters for tips and ideas. So that was another form. Constant Contact is the program that I use. I do pay for that. You do have to add team members. I do that for my team for recognition. And I also started doing it every other month for my customers, that there's a coupon in there. I talk about specific products I'm trying to promote. Do featured, I think I do like four featured products. If there's a new shipping code that's available, I'll put that on there for them as well. So it's not just for my local customers, it's my out-of-state customers. And I keep adding more and more people to that. Just like team members, every time we get new team members, I have to go in to my Avon reports and add them to my constant contact list so that I'm making sure new team members are getting that team recognition and tips email as well. So, take the time to learn things. I did a course on blogging. One of my friends that's not with Avon, she just does a lot of different marketing things, took a blogging course of hers, and I'm still learning on that. I'm still doing it. I'm still making mistakes, but I'm just going to keep doing, just keep trying. And the more you practice and do, the better that you'll get at those things. So one of the other things I want to tell you about is reading books like Build It Big is through Direct Selling Women's Alliance. This is a great book, and I've done trainings with this in the past. There's actually a workbook with that, and I go back and refer to that over and over. This book I've had forever. This is through my upline, Lisa Wilbur. She's written different marketing tips, and I've had this book probably, I don't know, got at least 15 years. I'm always reading different books. Bob Berg is an excellent writer. Just all kinds like this is Endless Referrals. I don't know if you can see it in the back, but my bookshelf there. That's just, I mean, I have some books. I have a lot more that are packed away in my closet. But I use them, for quick references. I do a lot of reading. I do a lot of self-help books. I do, my daily devotions every day. I get into my Bible every day. So people say I don't have the time. Well, I work Avon full time. I do things with my church. I do Bible studies. My husband does two Bible studies a week. I do my team meetings locally that I do that I'm physically meeting with members face to face twice a month. I get on conference calls. Sometimes we have three or four conference calls, and they're in my calendar, and I may not be able to get on them live every week, but I go back and do the replays. So I could be up at 7 o'clock drinking my coffee, and I'm doing a replay. Or if my husband's not home that night and it's quiet, instead of sitting in front of the TV and watching a show I've seen probably, I don't know, five or six times, I'll just go on and do a training again, do a video again. We need to educate ourselves, and there's so many great tools out there. So I don't want you to miss out on those opportunities. There's no excuses, team. You want to make money with this business, you have to put the time and energy into it. And you need to invest in yourself. I mean, it's not about investing in me, to help me get the unit sales that I need. It's about me helping you, being a service to you, and you helping yourself. Go out there and do things. And you may fail several times before you succeed, and that's okay. It's like you fall down, get back up, do it again, try it, try something new, or reach out to me, ask for help. We have the product line with Avon, the customer insight line. There's so much information that's readily available at our fingertips. You just need to take the time and do something daily that's going to help you in your business. So I hope this little segment is helping you. If you have any further questions or you need some tips and ideas of activities, what you can do daily. Just out running errands. Always have books, have your business cards, have some samples with you. Don't be afraid to talk to somebody. Have an Avon shirt. Like today, I don't have an Avon shirt on, but you could wear a button. My van is wrapped with Avon, so people see me coming. They can't miss me. But always have something that you can leave with someone and get their contact information so that you can follow up with them. So those are a few tips for today. I hope you have a great rest of the week and share some of the things that you're doing this week. I'd love to hear from you. Or you could message me on this page or call me on my cell phone, 352-263-7329, if you need some help with anything. Remember, I'm here to be of service for you. Avon pays me to help my team members. I take it very seriously. And I hope that you all have a great week and wishing you lots of success, if I could say that three times fast. Have a good one, guys. Take care.